So let's get started. So what we have for the short presentation today is integration of Moodle LMS with proctoring tools to accomplish an integrated assessment platform. Okay, so this is what we have for the short presentation today. So myself is from 3E, and along with me on this presentation, we have Anmol, Viresh, and Suzy. Okay, so let's give a short introduction about what it is about and what are the key drivers. So let's look into some facts. Okay, so we all know that thousands of online exams are being taken every day. So even as we speak, even during this COVID-19 shutdown time also, so thousands of online exams are being taken. Okay, so for one or the other purpose, okay, for certification or otherwise. Okay, so obviously whoever are taking the exams or whoever is conducting the online exams, their objective would be do more with less. Okay, so do more online exams with less resources invested, less time, less cost, and less physical resources, whatever they are disposing of. Okay, so that would be the obvious objective for anyone. Okay, so why that objective is being accomplished? Okay, so what is the cost at which that it is accomplished? Is it accomplished at the compromise of some other major objective? Okay, so that is the major objective that we are talking about here. Okay, so is this online exam comfort is coming at the comfort of authenticity or integrity of the exam? Okay, yes, you have given a effective assessment platform and exams are being taken very comfortably. Okay, so both sides, the exam taker or as well as the other side, whoever are conducting the exams or the assessments, so they are the comfort of the technology and they are effectively handling that. But what is the cost of it? Okay, so what is the compromise being made? So at the authenticity. Okay, so whatever certification you are giving, so if your assessment is associated with a certificate, okay, so the certificate would obviously have more value if it comes with an authenticity of the assessment, right? So we all should agree with that, right? So now, what is the cost to ensure that authenticity? Okay, so now obviously you have brought in effectiveness doing the online exams, okay, and you have a consistency doing the assessments, everything you have in place. Now you would like to add more authenticity, and what is that cost involved? And what are the factors to be considered? Okay, so this is all where proctoring comes into picture. Okay, so in general, whatever we achieve, okay, say in terms of technology, whatever comfort we bring in terms of technology, okay, so as much as possible, we all should get close to the realistic conditions. Okay, so yes, we got this so and so comfort, but we are missing out in this factor. Okay, that should never be the case. That means technology hasn't replaced all your needs completely. Okay, so this is the same case even with the exams, assessments, anything, right? That is the same case. Okay, so you have brought in 50% replacement with the technology. So 50% of the things, whatever you are doing, you have brought in technology, and you are doing technology has replaced all the manual work or all other traditional process, but you are losing out on the rest of the 50%. That's never a good equation, right? So when you have to speak about the advantage of the technology, you have to replace everything end to end with the technology. So when you have to talk about bringing in the technology to take care of the assessment, you have to take care of the end to end picture of the assessments. Okay, so that is the key driver here. Okay, so now who are our target audience? Who should this solution help? Okay, so the target audience are any authorized training centers or assessment or certification agencies, whoever are doing these jobs of assessment and certifications for one or the other reasons, or typically online universities or any academic institutions. Okay, so for that matter, any institution whoever have the need to take the online assessments with or without e-learning delivery. Sometimes they will only deliver the e-learning content in form of different courses. Sometimes they are not at all related to delivery of the content, but just they are about they do the business job about assessing the proficiency of the test taker on various subjects. Okay, so for it could be any purpose. Okay, whatever is the purpose associated with the certification. Okay, so essentially, what I mean to say here is, it need not necessarily be connected fully with e-learning content delivery. Okay, so you may or you may not be responsible for the e-learning content delivery just because you are responsible for the online assessments. Okay, so these are the target audience for us. Okay, so now the solution or the proposed solution, it may help them in one or the other. Okay, so before we get to the final details, so let's take a look at the definitions. Let's not get into the bookish definition, but let's all try to set some base. What are online assessments? What is proctoring in general? Then what is online proctoring? Then of course, what is an LMS? Okay, so yes, let me not try to give the definition of LMS. So let's try to have some understanding of this, okay, so that we all are on the same page with respect to what we are going to talk about now. Okay, so now let's take an example of online university. Okay, so in university, it can be full-fledged online university, or it can be a regular university who is doing online programs as well. Okay, so they are delivering the e-learning content. Let's say, assume that they have put up some academic programs, and through those programs they are delivering online content. Okay, so then to call these programs as complete, let's say like at the end of this course delivery, they also have assessments. Okay, assume that they have a very clearly drafted assessment put up in place. Okay, in terms of evaluating the skills, in terms of evaluating the knowledge, or in terms of, you know, evaluating the attitude of the learner, whatsoever it is. Okay, so even they could have thought of psychometric assessments. Okay, so whatever they think is the best approach to have the evaluations done for the learners, they have put everything in picture, and they have a very good platform, okay, in terms of content delivery as well as in terms of effective assessment. Okay, so let's say they have brought in Moodle for this, and they are successfully able to deliver this, okay, the content and as well as the assessments. Now let's come back to the subject what we started with at the beginning. Okay, so the authenticity, the integrity of the exams. Okay, now the question is, what is the guarantee that the learner is being highly sincere as she takes the exams? What is the guarantee? Okay, so yes, your assessments are really good. If the assessments are done successfully, the certification is of real value. But who are you awarding the certificate to? You are awarding the certificate to the learner who have actually registered for your program, or you are awarding the certificate to the person who has taken the exam? There's no guarantee, it's one and the same. So technically, so it is may or may not be the case, but technically there is no guarantee. So in some cases it's possible. On the other side, the assessments are being taken as a teamwork. It is quite possible, right? Okay, so there is some teamwork being done, and they are completing the assessment, and the university would be ending up giving the certification to one person, whoever has registered. Okay, so this is the precise limitation that we are going to address. Okay, so now how do we extend the capability of Moodle to bring in the exam integrity? Okay, so whatever is otherwise an assumed exam integrity, how do we bring in the trusted exam integrity? Okay, so this is the capability that we are trying to fix. Okay, so we have to accept the one fact that we are not living in a plain world. Okay, So if it's all plain old, obviously there is no room for innovation of technology. There is no room for many other things to happen. And you can even imagine there are many jobs being lost if it is a plain old. Okay. So that different gaps or different thought process and the people being different with their approaches, with their attitudes. So these are all the things which lead to innovation of technologies. Okay, in a way, those innovations create more jobs. Those necessities create more jobs. Okay, so at a broader sense, we can link all of that to this subject as well. Okay, so now we talked about bringing in the trusted exam integrity, and we talked about integration of the Moodle LMS with online proctoring tool. Okay, so proctoring tool is meant for delivering the trusted exam integrity. Okay, so again, proctoring can vary in its operations, in its capabilities. Okay, so proctoring can vary from face recognition to live proctoring and fully automated live proctoring. Okay, so now you may have the choice of going with a third-party proctoring tool, a cloud-based proctoring tool, or if you have the bandwidth, okay, so you have the choice of bringing in your own proctoring tool. You can have, you can build in-house proctoring tool. Okay, so whatever is the proctoring tool, you have the proctoring tool on one side, which is fully reliable, or at least which takes care of your requirements. Okay, so it's necessary and sufficient for you. Because whatever are the necessary and sufficient requirements for you, it takes care of those requirements. Now, on the other hand, you have an LMS which is doing its job really, really well. The Moodle LMS which you have brought in, it's doing its job really, really well in terms of content delivery and handling the assessments. Now, the only gap that you want to bridge here is, if you want to handle these two things separately, you require the learners to leave the LMS environment and get to the proctoring tool, finish their assessments, and then get the certification. Okay, so again, probably they may need to come back to the LMS and to continue from where they have left off. Okay, so this is the precise limitation. Okay, so we are talking about bridging that limitation and what are the technologies, tools, and the standards. Okay, so now we have the proctoring tool, which is working more like a LTI provider. Okay, and on the other side, you have the Moodle, which can work. Moodle is already capable of working as a LTI consumer. Okay, of course, Moodle can work as a LTI provider as well, but for this requirement, Moodle's capability as LTI consumer is what matters. Okay, so before that, I just forgot to mention one point here. Okay, what is an LTI first? Okay, so LTI is the global standard. Okay, so which is maintained by IMS. Okay, so basically, it talks about the interoperability between different learning tools. Okay, so maybe you can have an assessment tool, or you can have a different virtual classroom tool. Okay, so you can have a learning management system. So LTI is the standard which connects all these learning tools seamlessly. Okay, so that is the what LTI is about in brief. Okay, so without leaving one environment, you can launch another proctoring tool from your environment. Okay, so and all single sign-on, everything is taken care of. The way it works is you have to provide the launch URL on the consumer side, or launch URL of the provider, as well as the key and the secret. So then your learning tool are set to work fully seamlessly with one another. Okay, so that is in brief how it works. And for those who don't know much about LTI, probably they can visit LTI specifications on IMS Global site. Okay, so as of now, I think LTI version 1.3 is the latest standard. Okay, and if your proctoring tool already supports LTI standard, what you need to do is you need to see whether it has already provided or it comes with a plugin to be integrated with Moodle. Otherwise, you have to think of ways to integrate that with Moodle and provide your write up your own plugin. So, or if it is about in-house proctoring tool that you are developing, you have to follow the similar practice. So basically, using this LTA standard, you can bring in most of the both worlds. So without requiring the learner, or even for that matter, the other stakeholders, without requiring them to leave LMS environment, you can accomplish an integrated platform to deliver e-learning assessments at the same time of assuring the authenticity, okay, so integrity of the assessments or certifications. So this is how it all works. Okay, so bringing in best of both worlds and using the standard tools and technologies, we can think of creating an integrated platform to take care of the end-to-end requirements and to move towards a 100+ set replacement of the things that we have been doing in a traditional world, the 100% replacement of them with the technology. Okay, so it is just moving towards 100%. We still can't say it is 100%. So again, it's all the evolution game. Okay, so as we bring in more and more things, there will be more and more limitations still identified. And as we try to bring in different solutions, so we can go towards the accomplishments. Okay, so from nowhere, now this is a world where we kind of have a choice of going with the online learning. So learning has become online mostly. So today it's a choice. Probably tomorrow we don't know. Okay, so maybe with the situations. Okay, so now we have this COVID-19 situation, which is forcing the learning to happen more on online. Okay, so probably the percentage of online learners it's increasing. Okay, so probably if some situations like that repeat, okay, so we never know, right, down the line. Okay, so we never have the predictions. Okay, so probably online learning is no more a choice, but it's a compulsion. So learning has to be done only online. Okay, so it's something that can be assumed, at least at this point of time. We never know. Okay, so it may or may not be the case. So when that happens, obviously all the assessments have to be mandatory. All the assessments have to be mandatory done online. At the same time, the proctoring, online proctoring, will become more of a necessity than a comfort as well. Okay, so as we evolve, our needs will also evolve. So some of the needs will add to the comfort. Some of these needs will not be a matter of comfort, but it's more like a compulsion. Okay, it's something that we ought to do. Okay, so there is no other option. Okay, so this is what about extending the capabilities of e-learning all the way to the completely authenticated proctoring done. Okay, so yeah, so that is the brief introduction about proctoring. Okay, so now, so before we end up the presentation, let's talk about who are the beneficiaries. Any solution that we talk about, definitely we have to think of who are the stakeholders, how the solution is going to benefit them. So obviously here the stakeholders are the learners, and the other side, the online university or any such bodies who are taking the exams or who are taking the certifications. So what's in it for me? What is in it for me, for the learner, and what is in it for me, for an online university? Let's just assume it is being connected, it is being used by an online university. Okay, so obviously location constraints. Okay, so the learner can take the assessments at the comfort of his home. Okay, so he doesn't need to move to any other exam center or anything. Okay, so then logistic, obviously there are no logistic concerns. Okay, so because he doesn't need to move to any exam center to appear for the online exam, obviously there are no logistic concerns. At the same time, even for the university, then you don't need to worry about arranging for the transportation of proctors. Okay. So then again, depending on the way the proctoring is done, so maybe the proctoring can be done online. Okay, so the live feed is being taken and the proctor is sitting on the other side. Then he will be doing the live feed and doing the proctoring notes, etc. So depending on how the proctoring is scheduled for, probably a proctor can do the proctoring for maybe 12 to 16 candidates at once. Okay. Or he can do it for one or two candidates at once. Okay. So it depends on how it has been scheduled. Okay. So then again, depending on the kind and type of the proctoring, so let's say like even without a need for a proctor, okay, so human proctor, it can be completely replaced by automated live proctoring. Okay, automated live proctoring in the sense it can be done as record and review proctoring, or it can be done as completely automated in real time. Okay, so I mean it depends on the capabilities that you have on the proctoring tool that you are using. Okay. So then, depending on the way that you use, depending on the capabilities of the proctoring tool, depending on the method that you adapt to, so you may or may not have one or more of these constraints. Okay? So you may get a full or part control of on these constraints. So logistics, location, and schedule. Okay?
Hello, Pasula. Okay. 2 minutes left. Are you finished with the presentation? Do you want to answer any questions?
Yep, I think I'm almost done. Just one note okay. that I would like to add is
two minutes. Yeah, just okay. Thank you.
Yep. Okay. So yesterday, I think Martin was talking about Moodle Workplace, and so there in Moodle 3.9, I think Safe Exam Browser is also planned to be rolled out. Okay. So Safe Exam Browser definitely it adds a little, definitely it adds a considerable value to this exam integrity. Okay. So then let's say like in future versions, if Moodle LMS is made to be made to work with this proctoring capability, then definitely it will be a lot of value to the Moodle ecosystem. So I think I'm done. Any questions?
Okay, I think that's it. Thank you very much for your contribution. That was a great presentation. We will have to close this session and move on to the next one. And similar to yesterday, to join the next session, you will need to exit this one and start a new session for the next presentation. All right. Thank you again, and see you all at the next session.
Thank you. Thank you.